This is the YGTV News.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Friday the 1st of February. I'm Bouchra El Mansouri. The PDP on Territorial Waters Incursions. Tradewise Chess Festival Roundup. Special Olympics Team Gibraltar Update. TIEA Signing with Poland. And finally, Hafid Ouass wins YGTV's Daily Photograph Competition, Day 15. This morning, the PDP issued a statement on recent incursion into British Gibraltar territorial waters. They noted that they do not doubt the tremendous support the Governor gives to Gibraltar and how hard he works to fight Gibraltar's corner, openly and no doubt behind closed doors. However, he is not being supported sufficiently by the Foreign Office, and this is unacceptable. The PDP regrets both the evolution of this issue out of a fishing issue and the fact that it was not nipped in the bud by the government. However, Gibraltar cannot tolerate threats of this nature to its sovereignty. Formal protests are clearly not producing results, and the governor must now insist on the British government making available all necessary resources to enable the RGP to properly police our waters, including effecting arrests of anyone breaking our laws in our waters as if they were on land. The Governor has an important role to play under our Constitution, and if he is not resourced appropriately, it becomes impossible for him to fulfil his duties. Nikita Vitugov from St. Petersburg in Russia won the Tradewise Gibraltar Masters title at the Caleta Hotel on Thursday after a pulsating playoff final against three times winner and reigning champion Nigel Short of England. Four players, the above two, plus Maxime Vachier-Lagrave of France and Chanda Sandipan of India, tied for the first place on 8 out of 10 rounds of the tournament, necessitating a knockout playoff to decide the winner of the £20,000 first prize. The competition was a huge success, and we will await for next year's event. Team Gibraltar has won their first divisioning match against USA, then lost to Egypt in a hard-fought match. On 31st of January, they played for classification against Italy, winning 6-3, and against Greece, winning 8-2. Both of these matches tested the strength of this, the first attempt of unified floor hockey. This is a fast game with knocks and bumps despite well-padded hands, shins and ankles. The team's intensive training beforehand is now paying off. Morale remains high as they await the next round. The two snowshoeing athletes will be in competition on Saturday and Sunday. Gilbert Likudi QC, Minister with responsibility for financial services, has signed a tax information exchange agreement with the Republic of Poland. The signing took place in London at the Polish Embassy, and the Republic of Poland was represented by Mr. Witold Sobkow, Ambassador Extraordinary of the Republic of Poland in the United Kingdom. Following the signing, Gilbert Likudi and the Ambassador took the opportunity of discussing economic and commercial matters of mutual interest. Mr. Likudi also took the opportunity to comment that the timing of the signature coincided this year with the 70th anniversary of General Sikorski's untimely death in Gibraltar. And finally, Hafid Ouass is today's winner of Day 15 of our photo competition with this entitled picture, Stand Alone. YGTV's competition will continue to run daily until February the 8th. Photographs can be sent to info@yourgibraltartv.com. 5 entries may be submitted per participant. That's the YGTV News. Have a lovely weekend. We'll see you on Monday.